Third Sunday in Ordinary Time, PSC, the inaugural speech. We hear so often of inaugural speeches, especially at the start of the academic year and other ceremonies. During the inaugural speech, the orator gives a lineup of all the possible achievements to be realized during their term of office. At the beginning of Jesus' ministry, Luke presents Jesus during a homecoming, endowed with the power of the Holy Spirit. Jesus gives an inaugural speech by insisting on the fact that the mission is given by the Spirit. This inaugural lesson came shortly after Christ spent 40 days and 40 nights in the desert preparing for his public ministry. The anointing of Jesus is given by the Spirit of the Lord to bring good news to the poor, to the captives, the blind, and the downtrodden. Jesus has one message for them. It is the Lord's year of favor. There are many lessons to draw from this inaugural speech. First of all, we can see the place of the Holy Spirit in the life and in the ministry of Jesus. The latter always acts through the prompting of the Holy Spirit. We too, like Jesus, through our baptism and through the confession, through our confirmation, have the Spirit of the Lord upon us. In fact, the Spirit of the Lord is always upon us, especially through the sacraments. Christ has endowed us with a lot of gifts, and the Holy Spirit has given us all his gifts. This implies that Jesus has given his mission to each one of us. We are to continue this mission until the end of the world, when Jesus will come to judge the living and the dead. We must be involved in the life and mission of our modern world. In a world where there is a lot of consumerism, with very few rich people and very many poor people, we are called upon to preach the good news to the most dejected in the society. We are to reflect the merciful face of God to the suffering world. Secondly, we can identify the importance of the Bible in the life of every Christian. The inaugural speech of Jesus is from the scroll or the Holy Scriptures at that time. This shows that Jesus read and understood the Scriptures. Today we have a priceless gift of God in the inspired books of the Bible. Let us show true appreciation for that gift by using it to build up a better knowledge of the Christian faith, which it teaches us. There should be a Bible in the home of every Christian. It should not be an ornament on the shelf, but a fountain and source from which we can draw strength and refreshment in the daily practice of the Christian faith. The Bible contains the good news. The good news is that we are loved, we are noticed, we are valued, no matter our social status. We must make ourselves good news so that others may come closer to God. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
God sends me forth, all to witness the kingdom of Christ among all the nations. Called to announce the grace of salvation to all. My spirit rejoices in God, my Savior.
The Spirit of God rests upon me. The Spirit of God consecrates me. The Spirit of God bids me go forth to proclaim God's peace and joy.
Oh, the word of my Lord.
Eva.
Evangelium, your Bible diary for 2019, a year of grace, is now available. Be the first to buy it. Evangelium, the Bible diary that provides you with the Word of God and daily meditations. Evangelium, a sure guide for personal prayers for you and for your family. Evangelium, you are assured to walk in the presence of Christ with the church throughout the year. For your orders, contact us through the numbers 675-390021 or 694-438209.